Hello, I'm going to do the Capricorn weekend energy for January 8th and 9th. The girls are a little wound up. Gertrude's so funny because she'll take a toy and then she'll stick it in Lexi's face and say, "See what I have that you can't get." So that's what's going on right now. And Lexi gets irritated by it. All right, so this may or may not resonate with you. If it does, take what does. If it does not, leave what does not. All right, we have the four of Pentacles. We have the Four of Swords, we have the Nine of Swords, we have the Devil, we have the Chariot, we have the Two of Pentacles, we have the Ten of Cups, one of my favorite cards, we have the Justice card, we have the World card, we have the Ten of Pentacles, the Five of Wands, and the Seven of Wands. I feel like it's... Oh, and then I have this one that wanted to come out. Love it. That's one of my favorite. That's my favorite card in the deck, the hanging man. In any deck. I feel like it's... For some reason, in my mind, it's like time to change things up. I feel like you're tired. I feel like you're holding on. You're keeping to yourself. I think yesterday's reading, the daily reading, was clearing the clutter, like clearing up your mind. Like there's a lot of thoughts that you have going on, and I feel like that's kind of falling over into this weekend. It's still about that, trying to clear that up, taking that time to yourself, that alone time to think things through and to look at things from a different perspective. I feel like there's something that you keep going back and forth with. Maybe there's something that you want to do that makes you happy that you just haven't pursued, and you're like, yeah, you know what, I'm going to go for it. I'm finally going to take that step, and I'm gonna go for it. Let's see, I'm gonna try something and then I'm gonna use the same cards as clarifiers. I was just feeling like changing it up. You're holding back, you're tiptoeing around something. You're tiptoeing around a subject, a something. You're holding back from something. You're kind of, I feel like it's, I almost feeling like you're putting out little hints to someone. You're putting out little cues to someone about something, and they're not picking it up. Like you're putting out feelers for a situation towards someone else. And you're like wondering if they're going to pick that up or not. All right, we have the Four of Swords, and that's about taking a rest after a difficult situation, or it's all, you know, it's like taking that time out. Delayed, okay? I feel like, again, that's something that's long overdue, and I feel like you need this recharge moment, like you need this recharge thing, that this is something that you've kind of put on hold. Tired, okay, Nine of Wands, tired, exhausted, but hang in there, okay? The Nine of Swords, having that scattered energy, I just feel like there's something that you're going back and forth with. Putting out little hints, but I feel like those around you aren't listening. Who you're trying to put those hints out to isn't hearing it. I feel like it's finally time to take action in this situation. It's like you've kind of done this for a while. So now it's like time to move forward on this. Yeah, it's time to take action on something. It's time to get to it. We have the Queen of Cups. I feel like this helps you emotionally. I feel like this helps you to feel more balanced. This helps you to feel like you're working towards your Ten of Cups. Death card. Could have to do with a Scorpio. Maybe there's something that you have to deal with a Scorpio, but it also could be that you're hanging on to something that isn't really doing you any good anymore. And with that being next to the Devil card, it could be that, you know, there's something that's kind of negative or toxic or that's not very good that you are holding on to, that you realize that, okay, I gotta let that go. It's time for me to take action, okay? Especially with this Knight of Wands, this Page of Wands, the Chariot, it's like energy is like pushing you forward. Death card is about transformation and transition between these two energies here. I feel like that's what we have, is that we have this that you're dealing with here, and then I feel like this is the transition, kind of that in the middle. And then over here we have the Ten of Cups, the Justice in the World, and that's like that positive, like, yeah, like I'm so glad that I made that change. And I love this one because she's just like flying free, you know what I mean, and feeling so happy. And Temperance is about compromise, and it's about patience and being patient and waiting for those things that will fall in your favor, and not pushing or rushing anything, but also taking care of those things that you need to take care of, you know, actually letting go of those things that you need to let go of, and then embracing the change and moving forward. The World card, yeah, there's some things you have to empty out. There's some things that you have to deal with. There are some things that you have to confront and work through. And I feel like this is sort of the same energy as what we had on Friday, is, you know, clearing out the clutter, the mental clutter. And those things take time. That's not... And I know that it can be frustrating. It's like, oh, I just want to feel better now. I just don't want to go through this. And it can take months. It can take years to work through this stuff. But being on that path, it's rewarding to know that you're on the path and you want to make changes. And yes, like you're going to go back to your old habits and it's going to be frustrating. But it's almost like those old habits, they're not the same anymore. And you're seeing that, yeah, like that's not what I want. Like you're seeing things from a different perspective. You're making those choices that are best for you. You're kind of putting those coins away. You're putting that knowledge. You're putting those things away for yourself, for the future, to see that, you know, when you go back to those old ways, it's like, yeah, this doesn't feel right anymore. I feel like I'm in transition. And I feel like that's what this reading is that you're in transition. You're realizing that you've got to change. You're kind of holding on to the new, but you're also focusing, I mean, you're kind of holding on to the old, but then you're focusing towards the new, and you like want change, but you're not really sure how to do it. You're kind of putting feelers out there, and I feel like my favorite card, another one of my favorite cards. All my favorite cards came out in this. We have the Ten of Cups, which I love that card because it's so cozy. And then we have the Seven of Cups, which I feel, you know, is that Disney princess castle at Disney. So that came up. The opportunities are there. The opportunities, you know, are, the possibilities are endless. And to think about those positive things and to make those changes for yourself. And like I was saying, is I feel like you're sort of in this transition state. you know, you have, you're in the process, but at least you're in the process. You're recognizing those things. And that's what's really important. If you can recognize it to begin with, you can recognize those things that you need to change. And that's a huge step, being able to recognize that and then taking the steps to move forward and freeing yourself and changing things up and looking at things from a different perspective. And the opportunities just open up. But like I said, this is something that can take a long time, and you, there are times when you do kind of go backwards, but it's like I said, I feel like when you're making that change, it just doesn't feel like it used to. And you're like, yeah, okay, yeah, I really can close the door on that because I tried to go back to that and it just didn't work anymore. It's not feeling the same. All right, let's get... Animal Oracle card and close out with that. It's like the Death card. I'm kind of focusing on that. It's like the Death card is letting go of something that is no longer useful for us, but having that transition and transformation. So that's almost like what that is the Death card is in the middle of these two things, you know? And that's what the Death card is about. Snake spirit, time to heal. I definitely feel there are some things that you need to heal from. Healing and becoming stronger. And that's what I was saying, is that I feel like this weekend is that time again that you need that alone time to work on things. And then we have chameleon spirit, act as if you know you're embracing this positive, focusing on the positive. Act as if this has already happened for you so you can embrace that and be in that energy and not be in this energy. Maybe making a vision board. That could help. A vision board of all these different things. Like I've said before, in my phone, when I see pictures of things that I like that really make me happy, I have this little folder within my phone, you know, if you don't want to do like an actual message board with all that, but having that in my phone. And so I have this album in my phone, and when I'm feeling like I'm a little frustrated, I'll look at that album and I'll look at all of those things that I've put in there, those pictures or those sayings or those poems or whatever those things are that I've put in there. And I look at that and it makes me happy. And it gets me back into that energy and like, yeah, like those are the things that I like, and it changes my mood and my energy around. And then that can help you to continue to move forward and to continue to heal. I definitely feel that there's a lot that you need to heal from. But you can do it. You can do it. A lot of steps, a lot of things going on here. But having that ambition and the will to want to stand up for yourself and make the choices that are best for you, that's the most important thing. All right. Thank you so much for watching. As always, stay positive, stay safe, and I will see you next time.